तिलक लगा के मिट्टी का तू बाजी आज लगा ले। ओ तिलक लगा के मिट्टी का तू बाजी आज लगा ले। तुझ में जो चिंगारी है उस शोला आज बना ले। जान लगा के खेल खिलाड़ी, ओ जान लगा के खेल खिलाड़ी, साथ हमेशा स्पोर्ट्स इंडी। शान बढ़ा तू रहे अगाड़ी, जीत की भाषा स्पोर्ट्स इंडी।
Hello, good evening and a very warm welcome. This is Vineet Dev welcoming you all for a brand new session of World of Sports. Sports Indie presents World of Sports produced by Meeti Crew. Well, as we see to the different aspects of this industry, this sports industry, there are many more features of it when you look into it. As a player, as an athlete, you get to know many more things when you learn those aspects. But there's one more aspect that we're going to talk about today is the physiotherapist. There's always a term called as doctor. Whenever you need him, you go to him, you approach to him, you ask for the remedies and he gives you the solution. And in World of Sports, it is the physiotherapist who looks after all these aspects. So there's one of our personalities who's along with us, who's going to join in for today's session. Well, as I said, physiotherapist is a person who always looks after you as an athlete. When you work on any mode of this industry called the sports industry, there's something or the other that tends you to hurt. And then there's one person who gives you those remedies and makes you out of it and gives you the best solution. Dr. Suraj is along with us. So let's join him for this session of Sports Indie Presents World of Sports produced by Meeti Group. Dr. Suraj Vajaji, a very warm welcome. Thank you so much for joining in.
Thank you so much. First of all, I would thank ET Group and Mr. Amay Mone to giving me a platform to speak. I am delighted to be here.
Absolutely, sir. As it is always being said, a physiotherapist is a person who is always at the backside, and players are the one who is always being seen on screen or, you know, on your television screen and everything. The players are a known face for everybody. But the physiotherapist is someone who works at the background and helps the players to achieve their goals. So you're doing a great job as it is known to us. But I just want to know, at the starting of this phase, where did it started and how did it started, your journey?
It started when I was like good in studies. I wanted to be a doctor. And my parents just took me to a doctor who was a family physician. He just said, I just asked him, what's a good field now in doctor, in medical field. He said there is a field called physiotherapy that's going to come up more better in some coming years. I just found it more interesting. I just asked him more about it and I just felt, okay, let's go for it, and definitely if there is a scope in future, we need to go for it. That is where I started thinking about it, and after college, I just took my admission in D.Y. Patil, Pune, where I got my admission in physiotherapy, and from the journey started.
So
after that, it's all good.
Yes.
Correct.
Absolutely, sir. As it is always being said, you know, there's a doctor for all the remedies that you want. And when we speak about physiotherapists, sports industry is growing. And along with that, the demand for physiotherapists is also growing. So I just want to know any challenges that you faced while being a physiotherapist or studying about the stuff that you wanted to know about it. What were the challenges that you faced at that time?
Look, first of all, physiotherapy for some people were like, it was new for them. So we need to like, everything was before medicines. And physiotherapy was away from medicines, getting you better. So that was the first task for us, just to make people realize that if there is a other thing that can work for you is a physiotherapy, rather than the medicines. And in physiotherapy, there are hardly any side effects you can say, because it was everything good for you. And that person who is sitting can definitely be able to walk. A person is lying, they able to walk or run. That's what physiotherapy can do for a person's life. It can change a life to a very good level.
Absolutely, sir. And as you were saying about medicines and all, a physiotherapist provides as a magician, I would say. He does all the stuff on those athletes and makes them better so that they can enhance in their future time. But I just want to know about a couple of challenging cases that you have had in your career and the therapy method that you use for them.
Yep. There are a lot of weeks. Every day is a challenge for us because every patient is a new patient for us, and definitely it's everything different for everyone. So we have to be always on our toes to just help people out. And like this, if a case if we need to discuss, maybe we can take a player's case. Like during my time in Kabaddi, we had a very good player who was a Raider called as Maninder Singh. And just before the tournament started, he just got injured. And it was his ACL, that's a major ligament in knee, that got grade 2 tear. And we need to like, he was really wanted to play again, but if a grade 2 ligament tear happens, it's really difficult to come back to the field at this, like a very quick time. So we just rehabilitated him for at least 2 to 3 weeks. And after that, he played so well that he was a third Raider points in the like in the Kabaddi league at that time. That is where, as a challenge, when you get it out, you need to like just prove it out, and the player himself is happy and the team then just works more better. So that is where the challenges do work for us, and that is what every person should take it, a challenge, and just move on with that.
Absolutely. Now, as speaking about the Pro Kabaddi has proven as a boon for every other player who's related to this field. On ground basis is a different stuff, but moving on to a commercial stuff as like Pro Kabaddi, it is on a different level. So how did you manage to move on with this Pro Kabaddi players and everything, sir?
Look, Kabaddi, it was always a very good game, but after changing some rules, like how the like the test cricket, it got changed into a T20, and you just got the people attracted to that. Like same in Kabaddi, there were some rule changes around, and that created a lot of attraction to the people. And so like a fast moving game for half an hour, like 15 minutes of break, and then in a half an hour game, there is a the team that wins or lose. And yes, a sports definitely gets up when there is a good, you can say, viewership around it. And yes, every sports has a you can say a good background, and we just need to keep leveling it up.
Well, sir, moving on with your career, as we say, you know, but how would you approach a patient who refuses to work with you or follow your treatment suggestions or something? How do you deal with them?
Look, first of all, we need to always make the patient calm, understand his issues, and make them realize what is good for them. And if he's not ready, just explain the people who are around them, who is there with them, and just make them more comfortable. Once they know what is really good for them, they will definitely allow you to just help you out. And once you help you out, the next thing is the happiness what you see on their face.
Like, which was the most challenging case that you handled in Pro Kabaddi? Who was that player who tend to, you know, get injured some or the other time, and then you had to treat him continuously? Was there any challenges that you faced in that time?
Look, yeah, definitely. Like, it's a very tough game. It's a Kabaddi. So definitely the players do get injured while practicing also and while doing matches also. So like every day, if there is a like this intense game that's going on, definitely injuries are bound to happen. But it's a part and parcel of our sport. You take it on the chin and just move forward. We just treat them better. Like when they come back to the hotel, and we just keep fixing them up so that they're much better the next day, and they're back to the game what they love it. So like for every player, like the injuries do come, but the things like the positive what we need to create in them, because a injury can definitely destroy the career also, but at the same time, a physiotherapist's work is to just get that positivity back to that person, get the player back to the field, and get the best out of him. That's what a physiotherapist has to do.
Sir, I saw a photograph of yours with Akshay Kumar. I mean, he's one of those fittest artists in this industry.
Yeah.
And fitness or, you know, yoga, gymming, anything. There's one name that comes to your mind is Akshay Kumar. Did he ask you for any tips on these stuff? Like, how do you have to deal with if you get to tend to, you know, get injured or something like that? Did he ask you any remedies?
Yeah, like when he was a co-owner of our team, definitely he used to like ask us to what all you do just to prevent injuries, like after intense training. And we used to tell them ki we are giving them the ice bath. That's what we just let the players after intense training go for an ice bath, so that all the muscles which were in a lot of little vigorous training used up, they just cool down, so that the injuries are not there in future and the muscles works much better for that person again. That was the tips we discussed regarding
correct.
That.
Correct. Sir, as I said, I mean, there's always a dream that you always tend to look out, or there's something that, you know, provokes you to do this stuff. Which was that point, or which was that person who inspired you to be a physiotherapist? Who was that person?
Look, actually, first of all, my parents were always there. They wanted to, like, they wanted someone to be a doctor in the house, and always they used to tell me even to always help people. That's what the aim was. And I wanted to be a doctor from the childhood. As I like in our school days, so ask us what you want to become. I just wanted to say doctor. I want to become a doctor. So after a period of time, when I realized, definitely there is a time where I need to like go for more better studies. So I went to Diva Padil Pune, where I took up the admission and the practical stuff. What all that really requires during your medical time, you need to be like more interested in doing it. Get upgradation each and every time. Like every time the research comes up, you need to get upgraded each and every time, because the more your tools you are in your hand, definitely you can get a more better patient out of the pain. So that's what we always, as a doctor, has to keep upgrading ourselves so that it's good for our society also.
Absolutely, sir. Just wanted to have an overlook about your career. Like how many patients have you treated so far? How many people have gone through this treatment that you have done?
Look, it's really difficult to just count the people, because if you start counting the people, you really, like, it's a, like, the day will get end. So, like, every day we say, just say, keep people come to us hoping that we are going to be the person who's going to be helping them out. And that is where we, as a physio, as a doctor, just try and give our best shot so that they are happy when they leave their clinic, leave the clinic. So that's what, when we go to the clinic, it's a positivity that we create around the people, and that's what helps them out.
When going on with this field, like pro kabaddi or any other aspects that you look for, how do you look at the team and yourself as a team member when you move on as a physiotherapist?
First of all, yeah, we need to always get a bond between the players, get them some more comfortable so that they are very free to talk to you regarding their injuries also, regarding what they want from you also, and then the process starts forward. It's not about the treatment at the start. It's, so bonding becomes a first major part of our team. Then there is a treatment that goes, like, we assess the patient, we talk to them, what's their strength, what's their weakness, because everyone do have their strength and do have their weakness also. So strength, we can always get them better, but if there is a weakness, that there is a weakness in any patient's any player, just try to improve on that weakness so that it gets into, translate into the stronger area for him. So that is where we just create an atmosphere for them.
Absolutely. Like how do you measure your effectiveness as a physio when you work on with some great players of this sports arena? How do you look after that?
Look, when a player definitely does good, he plays a match better, or he finds himself better in that position, in that space, that happiness what you see and the movement what you see from him, that's why you say yes. What we, and if a team wins, definitely you feel very proud of it.
How does the international players, you know, cope up with?
Yeah, the pro, like the international players, like they are still a player, definitely. But for them also, the languages do matters a lot for everyone. Like from, if they are coming from some Korea, somewhere from other countries, definitely for them, like getting the barrier is the first important thing. And then once they are more comfortable with you, definitely they do share their like what their strength and weaknesses are. And once everything is like the bonding is better, the output is always a good stuff for them.
Like as an osteopath for India's handicapped men's cricket team, you have worked with them also, you have treated them.
Yeah.
And how was that experience?
It was a very good experience, first of all, because working with the disabled people, it's always a great challenge. And yes, if you just, the osteopathy works like you align the whole body. And if one part of the body is not in a stronger point, you can't change that thing. But the other part, definitely, you try to improve so much that works as the other part of, like, the visible part doesn't get involved in that area. That is where the effectiveness comes out of it. And yeah, we were lucky enough, like, we won the World Cup at that time. It was the first time that India won the World Series in the Indian handicap cricket team. That's in England in around 2015. So that was a really proud moment for us because, if our country wins, definitely everyone feels very proud of it.
Absolutely. So being a part of the World Cup winning team is always a great experience. But in your initial stages, in your initial career, when you started as a physiotherapist, when you were approaching, many people approach to each other, like, you know, I'm working on these aspects. How do you deal with this? But is there anything that you have done out of the box? Like, there's always a theory that we go on with it and we treat our patients. But is there any situation, you had any situation in your life that you had to think out of the box and then something out of the box came out and you treated any patient?
So definitely, it's like patients do go to other doctors also and they're not able to fix it up. It means something was lacking it. There was something missing link that we need to find it out. That's why we say think out of the box. And that if you start thinking out of the box, definitely there is a way that he finds your way to the end of it. So yeah, as a chiro, as an osteopath, as a physio, the tools what we have in your hand, definitely makes you think out of the box and that gets the person more faster recovery in their daily activities and all these things. That's why we always say, don't be just be limited in one space. Keep thinking out of the box. That's where you like dwell for better.
Well, in this session, we talk about, you know, sports ecosystem, how it works, how physiotherapist is more important. As I said, I mean, in the previous areas that you would see, a few years back, there was no physiotherapist who used to treat those players. There was only a term called doctor. And now at this stage, in these aspects, there's always one or the other doctor for every aspect of our body part. And physiotherapist is something, you know, you tend to look after him. Okay, these are the things that I'm going through. I have to meet a physiotherapist and the cases that you have handled. Which was the most extreme case that you handled? It was tricky enough that you had to do something or the other for that player or any other person?
If you just take yesterday's case, recollect yesterday's case, there's a woman who just came from Goregaon, a little far from here, from Tarzan. So she came, she had a disc issue in her back spine. And one of her spine, the vertebra, was transferred a little forward. That's because a lot of pressure, she was not able to walk for at least 2-3 minutes also. So the husband got her, she was crying. She said, the doctor said, I need to go for surgery or else I will get paralyzed. I said, don't worry, just let me see what's the case of yours is. I just pulled her down. I just saw her x-ray, I saw her MRI. And I said, just let me work right now. Let's see how it works for us. After a session, she was able to walk for 7 minutes. The person wasn't able to walk for 2 minutes. She was able to walk for 7 minutes and she was so happy. After that, she felt, yes, this is the person who's going to fix me up. So that is where we say every day is challenging where people come with a lot of issues, with a lot of they believe what this person can definitely help me out. And yeah, we need to just stand on it and help them out.
Absolutely, sir. It's my pleasure that I am taking this session with you. And in a short while, even Supriya ma'am will join with us. But when we speak about a physiotherapist, what are the main aspects that you expect from a physiotherapist? As an artist, when I work, I always take care of my throat, my nose, my voice. But when we speak about a physiotherapist, what are the aspects that basically a physiotherapist looks after in an athlete or in any other person?
First of all, the discipline. That's what we say. Discipline plays a major role in everyone's life, and definitely in athletes' life, it plays a major role. Like what time you sleep, what time you get up, definitely there has to be a sleep pattern, proper sleep pattern. The diet plays a major role, and the exercise routine. Because everyone has to go with this discipline. If there is a missing link in this, definitely the person is going to have some trouble today or tomorrow. So we say just have these three things together, and that positivity, that the thinking what you keep always in the day-to-day life, that matters a lot.
Absolutely. You might have faced, you know, there might be many aspiring physiotherapists or the young guys who tend to move to this physiotherapy world. What would you advise to them?
Yeah, first of all, it would be more interesting. Like just take up the physiotherapy as a course, as a doctor's stuff, in more interesting way, and just keep upgrading yourself. A lot of people, they just stick to one thing. We just stick, don't be stagnant to one thing because there are a lot of researches that have been going. Just keep updating yourself. There are a lot of fields where you can like just go for it and just try it out. Definitely it works very well. Like I did chiropractic, I did osteopath, I just did ABC practitioner, then I did dry needling, I did cupping. This is where a lot of things in your hands, and it gives a good results to the people.
Absolutely. As I said, I mean, it is my pleasure that I've been joined this session with you. But Supriya ma'am is along with us, so I'd like to invite Supriya ma'am to join in with the session.
Hello. Yes.
Very good. Hello, evening, ma'am. How are you?
Fine. Yes.
Ma'am, we are just having a word with Dr. Suraj about the world of physiotherapy. As we said, you know, this is world of sports, but physiotherapy is something that we are looking after at this moment. And for a sports person, being concerned about the physique is more important, as it is always being said. But coping up with the climate and environmental changes is always a challenge. According to you, ma'am, what should a sports person, you know, do to tackle these challenges? What do you feel, ma'am?
I think coping up with the climate, yes, it becomes sometimes a challenge, but their hard work and their dedication, their fitness matters for this a lot. And nowadays, now say with this all fitness coach aligned with all these players, they are making them aware how to cope up with this climate change. The specific some stimulation chambers also has been created at different facilities. So I feel coping up with the climate change is not a big issue. Especially for the players in the multi-season country like India. And maintaining immunity is best. So everyone is aware that immunity matters a lot for each and every sports person. And surest ways to tackle this challenge is, I think, immunity. So doctors and all... specifically sports, in sports medicine, lot many importance is given on immunity, fitness, exercise, diet. So I think this whole ecosystem for sports player is the is important as far as climate change factor is concerned. So according to climate change situation, players should manage their way, the exercise, the diets, practice, of course, in the consultation with their physician, dietitian, and coach. That is what I feel.
Absolutely, ma'am. Dr. Suraj, I want to move on with you. In India, you have moved on with the teams, you have worked with them, you have treated them. But moving international, on an international level, moving out of India, the treatment that has been given to the players is something different. And what we tend to give our players is something different. Do you feel the differentiation in the treatment that will be given to the players? How do you see to it?
No, actually, the thing is like, at the end, giving out a better results than the other people. So the treatment is not so much different, you can say. But at the end, what matters is the result. The player is able to perform that well at the highest standard level also. Like in cricket, if you say, definitely we are at a good level. In Kabaddi also at a good level. In Olympics this year, you can see definitely there are a lot of medals we could get it. So yeah, it's all better from our side, from our country also. So I don't think there's a difference in the treatment also.
Well, ma'am, how important do you feel that physiotherapist to the sports ecosystem is? And do you think every player should consult with a physiotherapist from the beginning of their career? How do you see to it, ma'am?
We can't say that from the beginning someone should consult, but I feel physiotherapy is an unavoidable part of every player for maintaining his and her fitness. Because anyhow, once the player starts his career at say state level or maybe national level or international level, he comes across some injuries or something like that, or maybe other challenges what he is facing during his career. So considering this all challenges, yes, physiotherapist plays a very big role in sports career. And secondly, considering the position of physiotherapist in sports ecosystem, I think it is topmost position really, because even though sometimes for like bigger injuries, the players has to undergo some operations and everything, and coming out of that major injuries or major operations, like psychologist plays a bigger role as a part of ecosystem. Similarly, physiotherapist plays a very, very big role to gain some flexibility again, and to come to original situation as a player. So because of only that fitness can be achieved, and rest of the elements in ecosystem with always works for you. So I suggest everyone should have physiotherapist. Yes, it is very much required. In India now, the awareness has started a lot nowadays. Earlier that was not in much that awareness related to getting consultation from physiotherapist was not there. But slowly that has started, and now sports players are much aware that how they have to maintain their flexibility, how to maintain their fitness, and yes, physiotherapist plays a very big role in that. Yes, absolutely. And thanks to
Suraj. Suraj, I want to move on to you. You personally look fit. You're young at your age. Was there any situation in your life when you came across a player who was, very much aware about your terms and working profile, but then too he was like, okay, I know what I do best. And then again, he came up to you and said, no, you were saying something correct and I had to follow this. Did that happen with you too?
Yeah, definitely. It did happen. It happens like there was a player who knew me before. And I treated him first, and I said, you need to move like this, because his movement was not looking that good. I just said, you need to work on this muscle and work on this rhythm of yours. That's looking a little restricted. If you can get this rhythm, it will definitely help you out. He said, no, I don't think so. It will not work for me. I said, okay, let's just do what you feel like. But after some time, like after a game or so, he felt, yes, that was the weakness of his. And once he got that into that thing, yes, I was right. And then he came back to me, said, you are right, just train me to this thing where I can get it better. And after that, for a week or so, we just trained to that movement and got it more better. And that is where, like, every team, they just have a good view of a player they are playing against. And they thought this was his weakness, but it turned out to be his strength then after a week or so. And that created a more benefit for our team and for him also. That was the, then he said, yes, I was right in that.
Likewise, when we say, a coach of the team, he always decides, he knows what are the strengths and weaknesses of his teammates as well as the opposition teammates. But when you as a physiotherapist, when you go on with your team, do you give suggestions to your player that his weakness is something like this, his strength is something like this, in terms of the fitness that the player has? Do you suggest any players of your team about the oppositions?
Look, that is more of a coach thing where they normally give their views that are more better into that thing. But yeah, if there is something they do ask us, like what you think about this player when he's moving around, we do share our views also. We think he's not that right side, it's not his strength point of view, or his left side is not moving that good. So if you can just attack that area, that definitely will help us out. So that is where we keep our point of view, which is required from the coach point of view, if it's a player point of view. Then we give our views on it.
Absolutely. Like learning about your journey as a physiotherapist that you have been working. And it's quite a great journey that you have succeeded so far. And now, what are the future aspects that you're looking to? What are the future plans of Dr. Suraj Vaza?
Look, there's always a plan, there's always a goal and a dream that a person wants to achieve, is to get to a highest level. So yeah, you just take a day by day as a step by step and just keep moving forward. All the things will come into your way. You just need to be simple. Just keep working hard on your things. Get your get upgraded each and every time as much as you can, and just see how it goes. That's because you just need to keep working hard for it. Have a good mind behind it, working your thing, and yes, everything has a way, and you just move on it and keep working hard. That's what I always say.
Absolutely. Supriya ma'am, we are talking about ecosystem, we are talking about the different aspects of this sports industry. Today we are joined with Dr. Suraj Vasa as a physiotherapist. You are looking out some of the different aspects, different culture of this sports industry. First of all, the credit goes to you as well as Meethi Group, the producer of this show. What is the main aspect that you feel is tend to, you know, describe physiotherapy or physiotherapist?
Physiotherapy is, I think, it overall it plays a very big role on the field, off the field. So means for now with all good the events coming up on various front at national level and international level, like Pro Kabaddi, he's associated with Pro Kabaddi League, Dr. Suraj. So I feel on the field also his role matters a lot. So overall, yes, physiotherapy plays a very big role. And just to share with you one thing, my sister is also a physiotherapist and she is dealing with such sports players. Yeah. So I feel that is most important part, and it is very well recognized in abroad. I mean, it's like US and UK, those kind of countries, and they have many research on physiotherapy as far as sports is concerned. Here in India, yes, we have started some research, but yes, that is very much helpful for the sports persons and sports industry as a whole. So physiotherapist is a very important factor of whole ecosystem.
Absolutely correct, Supriya ma'am. We all do agree with your questions. Dr. Suraj Vasa, thank you so much for joining in. But last word from your side. How do you see to this session and the future aspects about your life?
Definitely, it was very grateful from and thanks to Supriya ma'am for giving us a platform. Definitely, this gives a good platform to a lot of people who are looking forward what they want in future stuff and all. So yes, we say every step makes a way for big things, and this is one step where we are creating a bigger thing in future. That's what I always say for everything.
Absolutely. So thank you so much, Dr. Suraj Vasa. Thank you so much, Supriya ma'am. On behalf of the whole team, and this program is produced by Meethi Group, thank you so much to all our viewers watching us from all over the world. This was one of the part of this ecosystem that we talked about. Next Saturday, we'll move on with one more aspect of this ecosystem, of this industry called sports. So thank you so much to all. On behalf of Sports Indie Presents, World of Sports, this is the Vineet Dev signing off from here. Once again, Dr. Suraj Vasa, thank you so much for your precious time. Supriya ma'am,
most
thank
welcome.
You so much for
most
the great
welcome.
Initiative.
Thank you. Thank you, Vineet. And you did it very well. Good program. Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Most welcome.